Hello friends, my dear students, myself Sudhir Kumar Arora, and I am working as assistant professor in department of pharmacy at IIMT College of Pharmacy. Today I will start my topic with the subject pharmaceutical analysis. The topic which we are going to study in pharmaceutical analysis is fundamentals of pharmaceutical analysis. You might have heard the term fundamentals. Fundamentals are things which are basic behind the subject. If I talk about fundamentals, we'll start with the definition first. Definition of pharmaceutical analysis means that it is a subject or it is a branch of science which deals with identification of a substance which is used in various pharmacy practices. After doing identification, we can also go for quantitative estimation of the same substance. So this is the basic definition which is covering pharmaceutical analysis. So next we move to two terms, that is qualitative analysis and quantitative analysis. If I talk about qualitative analysis means we are doing analysis of a pharmaceutical which is used in various pharmacy practice for its identification purpose. What exactly the compound is, so that tells you the qualitative analysis. Second thing, we are go with the objective quantitative analysis. Quantitative analysis, as the word implies here, quantity word is used here. So it is adjective of quantity. So quantitative analysis implies that we are going for estimation of quantity of a substance. Substance means analyte. Analyte is something which is a product, which is a substance under investigation. So in short, I would like to say in one line that this is a subject which ensures what is the purity level of a substance. Suppose if I talk about food, I talk about a drug, these are the substances which need to be quality conscious. We should ensure that quality of the food or drug we are taking is 100% pure. If I say it is not 100% pure, it should be up to the limit that we can take it safely. So next we go to significance. Significance means importance, why this subject is existing. As we know, every subject in any field exists naturally. These are emerged because of certain reason. So here significance implies that suppose a drug is given, if somebody is taking, it is sold in the market, it should be pure. So we have to manufacture a drug and it moves from raw stage to the final product stage. So significance of pharmaceutical analysis includes, like, we are checking the level of purity of a drug at the raw stage. Second, we also ensure what is the composition of a drug substance. The final formulation which is coming in market, it may contain more than one component or it may contain one component. So we should know what is the quantity of each individual component in that substance. So pharmaceutical analysis through its fundamental help us to know that what is the amount of individual component in a given formulation. So next we can go for the level of impurity. As we know, there can be impurity through different resources. So level of impurity in a given substance, in a given sample of substance, in a given formulation, it should be to the level which is permissible. If it is more than that limit, it may harm any process, it may harm us safely, it may harm our health, as well as it may deteriorate any substance which is coming in connection with this. Let us move to next. How to do all this? Next question comes arise, how to do all this? That comes the techniques. If I talk about techniques, there are different techniques which can be employed for qualitative analysis as well as quantitative analysis. So first we'll start with the titration, because in this semester we are going to study about titration. So titration is a process. I would say, what is the definition of titration? So titration is the process which involves estimation of a substance, like we tries to find out the concentration of a solute substance which is in form of analyte to us, and we can also find out the percentage purity. I have used the term percentage purity. What is percentage purity? You must be knowing, percentage purity is a term which is used to tell you that how much a substance is pure. If I talk about a quantity of 100 gram for a given substance, any substance like NaOH, NaCl, whatever it can be, so how much pure it is, how much quantity exactly is present in that 100 gram. Suppose it is 99.5 gram in that 100 gram total quantity, then we can say it percentage purity of that NaOH substance or that NaCl substance, whatever is being available there, is 99.5%, because exactly it is 99.5 gram in that 100 gram total quantity. So that is called as percentage purity. So titration helps us to find out the concentration, it helps us to find out the strength of a solution, it helps us to find out the percentage purity level of a substance. Next comes the principle. Principle is backbone behind any process. So the principle behind the technique of titration is that we are depending on a reaction. So this process is depending on a reaction. That reaction include two components. One is titrant, second is titrant. So these two react with each other, like HCl, like NH, these two can react and make example of acid-based titration. So there is a reaction which is taking place quantitatively, means it has a defined stoichiometry. It has stoichiometry means there is a quantitative relationship between the two major reactants which are reacting to each other. Like one mole of HCl react with one mole of NaOH, giving rise to one mole of product final. So principle implies that there is a reaction, reaction complete, it takes place very fast, it reaches to an end point that is indicated by the help of an indicator. And there is respective equivalent quantity which made two reactants to react with each other in an effective way to complete the reaction. So this is the principle of titration. Next comes the example. We can, as I have just told you, that example can be like titration of HCl versus NaOH. In this, what we do, we take NaOH in the burette. We take it here and we take HCl solution here. So generally one of the concentration, one of the solution concentration is known to us, that is called as titrant. T-I-T-R-A-N-T. Generally it is taken in the burette during the process of titration, and we take another solution as HCl, like HCl solution, that is called as titrant. So titrant implies here, it in the end it comes D, so you can go for determine. So concentration of titrant is not known to us. So out of these two, one is known to us for its concentration, second is unknown to us for its concentration. So by this exercise we tries to find out concentration of a particular solution out of these two. The concentration, if I say, we can use another term for this, that is called as analyte. So in this titration, in this example, we are taking phenolphthalein as indicator. When we add phenolphthalein here, so NH we are taking here, phenolphthalein is getting colorless in acidic medium. So when we start doing titration, finally it get colorless at the end point. So with this, I just brief here the basic requirement, that reaction must complete, there must be two reactants, indicator must be available, and all these include the first technique, that is called as titration. So fundamentals of pharmaceuticals analysis includes qualitative and quantitative analysis objectives, and finally to check the purity of a substance given to us, which is very mandatory. Thank you.